Do you think flipping million-dollar houses or owning rental properties is going to be more profitable? Some of you may guess this right, but I bet a lot of you are going to guess it wrong. The answer? Rental properties. They'll make more money long-term. On one single-family $150,000 house, you can make over $200,000 on that one house. On a million-dollar apartment, you can make over $2 million on that one property. And I'm gonna give you the full breakdown and show you exactly where I'm coming up with these crazy numbers. Now don't get me wrong, flipping houses, making 15, 20% profit, you can make a lot of money. You can make $100,000, $200,000 on a deal. One of my students and I are reviewing a deal right now. It'll probably sell for about $700,000, $800,000, and it's got about $250,000 in profit on that deal. So I know it does work. You know, it's clear as day, flipping makes money. And if you've ever thought about looking for a mentor or looking for a coach, I do coaching as well. You know, if you want to check out the website here, it's thereblueprint.com. You can go jump on there and you can learn more about the options that we have to get you started inside of real estate. Now let's talk real numbers on rental properties. The beauty of this thing is you literally get paid forever on one deal. So take example, this property here, it's a duplex. It's not a crazy huge property, it's just a duplex. I'm gonna give you real life numbers on this. So the purchase price on this property was $11,000. The renovation expenses were $110,000. And then once it got done being renovated, the new appraised value was $220,000. So what I did is I went to the bank and got a refinance done on this property where the bank gave us a 75% loan to value. So what happened after that is I got a new loan from the bank of 165 grand. If you look at my costs, it's $110,000 rehab. It's an $11,000 purchase. It's a $15,000 that I had to pay in interest and holding costs to my lender. So I was all in for $136,000, which means on my refinance, when the bank gave me $165,000, I paid off all my debt and I was left with $29,000 in profit in my pocket. Now you continue here, each side rents for $1,200 a month and my principal, interest, taxes, and insurance is roughly $1,200 a month. So when you look at it, this is where I get the bigger numbers from. One house, 30 years later, this one duplex, 30 years later, it was worth $220,000 when I bought it. When I refinanced it, 75 LTV, so $165,000 loan, PI, principal and interest, was $885 a month. My taxes and insurance were $315 a month. My property management was $192 a month. And like I said, the rent was $1,200 a side. So let's look at what the numbers actually break down to be. 30 years later on this one property, I will owe $0. I won't owe a single penny on this property because my tenants will have paid off the property. The current value of the property is $352,000. So it went up from $220,000 to 352 because every year it appreciates about 2% in value. And in all reality, it's probably gonna be worth more than that. And my net cash flow is about $1,008 per month in profit. So 30 years later, $1,008 a month in profit is $362,000. And you get the depreciation. So you save money in taxes, you get the appreciation of the property value going up, you get the mortgage buy down, which means you owe $0, and you get the cash flow every single month. So if you look at this one house, you'll make over $714,000 on one duplex. Yes, there's gonna be some repairs and some maintenance and some turns. You know, knock off 100 grand of that or 200 grand of that. You make over $500,000 on one building worth $220,000 that you didn't have any of your own money invested into. That's on a duplex. Let's look at a little bigger one. Here's an 8-unit apartment building. I bought it for $325,000. Renovation was $200,000. Appraised at $770,000. 75% loan to value, $577,500. All in cost, purchase, reno, holding costs, and interest was $570,000. Bank gave me a loan of $577,000. So I made $7,500 when I bought this property. When I refinanced this property, my monthly PITI, my principal, interest, taxes, and insurance, was about $4,085 a month. Total rent for all units were $6,800 per month. So one building, 25 years later, it was worth $770,000. I purchased with the 75% LTV, which means I had $192,500 in equity from day one. My PI, my principal interest, is $3,016 per month. My TI, my taxes and insurance, is $525 a month. My property management is $544 per month. And my rent is $6,800 a month. So that's what that looks like 25 years later. I owe $0 because my tenants have paid off the mortgage. The current value of the property is over $1.1 million, again, because of a 2% increase in value. It's going to be higher than that. It's very conservative. Cash flow net profit of $2,714 per month. So 25 years later, $814,000 in cash flow. Total gain over 25 years, almost $2 million on one building that I didn't have any of my own money into. That's the power of rental properties. And again, yes, there's going to be maintenance, there's going to be vacancies, there's going to be returns. Knock off $500,000. You still made $1.5 million on one building. That's the power of rental properties. Nobody talks about numbers like these. Everyone talks about flipping houses and making some money, which is great. Do you think doing a few deals like this could change your life? Doing deals like this, one or two of these a year for the next 2, 4, 5, 10 years, yeah, it's going to change my life too. So looking back on my business, I wish I would have kept a few more rental properties, but that's what I'm doing now. I'm building my rental portfolio because I want that in the future. And there's a way to do this as well, using none of your own money, which is what I just showed you, how I was able to get into these properties using none of my money. It's called the BRRRR method. It's buy, renovate, rent, refinance, and repeat. And you can do this with none of your own money. You can borrow money from private money lenders to fund the purchase and the rehab of these deals, rent it out to a tenant, refinance it with the bank, and own this property with literally not a single penny of your money invested into this deal. I know it's true because I've done it. It's how I've built my almost $10 million real estate portfolio, is using the BRRRR method, B-R-R-R-R. It's how some of the most wealthiest people in the world have got into and own real estate, because they use other people's money to own real estate. People that own thousands of units have done it through the syndication model in apartment buildings. That's the beautiful thing about real estate. Most people think you need millions and millions of dollars to get into real estate and to own real estate, but they don't tell you the secrets of how to own real estate with none of your own money. So today we covered the power of rental properties and how much money you can make on rental properties, which nobody tells you those numbers. People just say, oh, you'll make $200-$300 a month in profit. No, $200-$300 a month in profit is not changing anybody's life. But when you look at numbers like that and you can make millions of dollars on one property, that can change your life. People don't talk about that. So we covered that, and we're going to cover the BRRRR method, where you buy, renovate, rent, refinance, and repeat time and time again to build your rental portfolio, to build your net worth, to build your cash flow, so you and your family never have to worry about money again. So if you want to learn about the BRRRR method, which is how I've built my entire portfolio, check out this video here called the BRRRR method, and it'll show you literally step by step by step exactly how to do what I've done and build an almost $10 million rental portfolio. So if this added any value to you, I never saw numbers like this. When I saw numbers like this, I was all in. So if this added value to you, make sure you smash that like button down below for the YouTube algorithm. It'd be greatly appreciated if you could hit that like button. Also comment below and let me know what your thoughts are. Do you want to own rental properties, or why are you hesitating on owning rental properties? Drop a comment below, hit that subscribe button and notification bell while you're down there. As always, I appreciate you being here, and we'll see you on the next one.